Good morning, students. In this video, I will discuss some numerical problems related to the chapter pressure. Okay. I have given four numerical examples on pressure. Okay. Let me consider one by one. Now, in the first example, see, a wooden box of weight 140 Newton is kept on table. The area of cross section of the box is 5 meter square. Calculate the pressure exerted by the box on the table. Okay. Now, see, here is a box on the table and the box is applying 140 Newton of force on the table due to its weight. Okay. Now, the area of cross section is given, that is 5 meter square. You have to find the pressure exerted by the box on the table. Area of cross section here the area of cross section of the box means the area of the base of the box. That means the area of contact between the box and the table is 5 meter square. Okay. So, force applied by the box on the table is 140 Newton. Area of cross section of the box is 5 meter square. That means the area of contact between the box and the table is 5 meter square. Okay, now we know pressure is equal to force by area of contact. So, here force is 140 Newton and area of contact is 5 meter square. So, required pressure is 140 by 5, that is 28 Newton per meter square. Okay, or 28 Pascal. Now, in the second example, a force of 200 Newton can produce a pressure of 20,000 Pascal. Calculate the area in semi-square on which the force shall act to exert the pressure. Okay. Now, force is given which is 200 Newton. Okay. And the pressure is given which is 20,000 Pascal. We have to find the area of contact. And in semi-square. Okay. Now, pressure is equal to force by area of contact. Now, if we cross multiply, pressure into area of contact is equal to force. Okay. So, area of contact is equal to force by pressure. Okay. See here. We know pressure is equal to force by area of contact. Okay. So, if we cross multiply, pressure into area of contact is equal to force. So, area of contact is equal to force by pressure. Okay. The force is given 200 Newton and pressure is given 20,000 Pascal. So, both are given in SI. Okay. So, we will find the area of contact in SI, that is meter square. So, the area of contact is equal to 200 by 20,000 meter square. That is, Now, we have to convert this meter square into semi-square because we have to find the result in semi-square. Now, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, we know. So, 1 meter square is equal to 100 centimeter square. That is 10,000 semi-square. So, after calculation, we will find the area of contact is equal to 200 by 20,000 into 10,000 semi-square. That is 100 semi-square. Okay. So, in the first example, the force is given, the force was given and the area of contact was given. We have to find the pressure. And in the second example, the pressure was given and the force was given. We have to find the area of contact. Okay. Now in the third example, the third one is also similar like the second one. A force of 250 Newton while acting on an area X produces a pressure of 1000 Pascal. Calculate the magnitude of X in semi-square. Okay. So, force is 250 Newton acting on area X and pressure is 1000 Pascal. How to find the value of X in semi-square? So, see, the force is given in Newton and the pressure is given in Pascal. So, the area will be, we will find the area after calculation in meter square. Then we have to convert this meter square into semi-square. Okay. So, pressure is equal to force by area of contact. That means, after cross multiplication, we will get that pressure into area of contact is equal to force. That means, area of contact is equal to force by pressure. Okay. Now, force is given 250 Newton. Pressure is given 1000 Pascal. So, X is equal to 250 by 1000 meter square. Okay. Now, we have to convert this meter square into centimeter square. Okay. Now 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. So 1 meter square is equal to 100 centimeter whole square. That means 10,000 centimeter square. Okay. So after calculation, we will get 2500 centimeter square. So the value of x will be 2500 centimeter square. Okay. I hope you understood. See, the force is given in Newton and the pressure is given in Pascal. So both are given in SI unit. So if we calculate, after calculation we will find the area in SI unit. Okay. So unit of SI, unit of area in SI is meter square. So after calculation we got 250 by 1000 meter square. Okay. Now we have to convert this meter square into semi square, because the answer, we have to find the answer in semi square. Okay. Now 1 meter is equal to 100 semi. So 1 meter square is equal to 100 semi whole square, that is 10,000 semi square. So after calculation we will get 2500 semi square. Okay. I hope you understood. If there is any confusion in your mind, please inform me. Now see the fourth one. The base of a wooden box measure 15 semi into 20 semi. It is placed on a bed. If the weight of the box is 60 newton, what is the pressure exerted by the box on the bed? Okay. So the base of the box, the length and breadth of the base of the box is given. Okay. So area of the base of the box is 50 into 20 semi square, that is 300 semi square. And the weight of the box is 60 newton. We have to find the pressure. Okay. Pressure is equal to force by area of contact. Now force is 60 newton and area of contact is 300 semi square. Now if you have to find the pressure in Pascal, that is in newton per meter square, we have to convert this 300 semi square into meter square. Okay. Now 300 semi square means 300 by 10,000 meter square. Why? If you have to convert meter square into semi square, we have to multiply the meter square into 10,000. And if you have to convert semi square into meter square, then we have to divide semi square by 10,000. Okay. I hope you understood. In the previous example, we had to convert meter square into semi square. So we multiplied it by 10,000 semi square. And in this example, we have to convert centimeter square into meter square. So we divided it by 10,000 meter square. Okay. So after calculation, we got 200 newton per meter square, that is Pascal. 2000 newton per meter square, that is Pascal. Okay. I hope you understood. So these are the four numerical examples I have given here. Rest you try by yourself, and if there is any confusion or any doubt in your mind, please inform me.